in this top half of the women's doubles draw. Well, the Chinese pair of Wang Yaxiong and Yu Xiaohan, two titles for them so far this year. Because not only did they win last week at the Macau Grand Prix Gold, but they won the Korea Super Series event as well. Christian Johannesson of Denmark is our umpire for this, and Cheryl Hassanor from Canada is the service judge. So the Olympic champions from Japan had a bye in the first round. No opponents for them. They are the number one seeds here as we look at Mizaki Matsutomo and her partner Ayaka Takahashi. So Steen, I assume they're still world number ones as we look at the head-to-heads, and that might surprise a few people. This is the third meeting between the two pairs, and the two previous occasions have both been won by Wang Yaxiong and Yu Xiaohan, and both in two games. The last time was in the semi-final of the Korean, which of course I was telling you the Chinese pair went on to win. So with the world rankings just come out, they do indeed remain at number one. So that means that this is their 127th week in total as world number ones. There you can see Ayaka Takahashi, 27 years of age, from Kashihara City in Nara Prefecture. Mizaki Matsutomo is 25 years of age from Aizumi Town, and she and her partner are playing their eighth consecutive China Open. Four quarterfinals and that final 2 years ago. Now there is confirming what I told you just a moment ago, that they had a bye in the first round. They've been in four finals incidentally already this year, winning three of them. Asian Championships, the Australian Super Series and the Japan Super Series, their second Japan title in their third final in Tokyo. So to Wang Yaxiong, my goodness, she's having a busy time, because last week she won her second doubles double in her career so far. First time was at the Malaysian Grand Prix Gold, and last week she won both the doubles and the mixed doubles. So the doubles double achieved twice now for Wang Yaxiong, the 23-year-old from Kuzhou in southwest Xinjiang province. So to Yu Xiaohan, she's 23 years of age. They have gone up three places in the world ranking to 27, because my notes said they were 30. So obviously they've gone up three places this week. And they are number 11 on the Super Series standings, which means they probably still have a chance of qualifying for the Super Series finals. Now you can see that they played Linda Effler and Olga Kornan of Germany in the first round. Just under the 30-minute mark for that match. So, this, in my opinion, one of the toughest draws across all the disciplines, this second round encounter. Olympic champions against a pair that's in such good form at the moment. Of course, this Chinese pair play together as juniors. They were silver medalists at both the 2012 Asian Junior Championships and World Junior Championships, where they lost in the final to Shin Sung Chan and Lee So Hee. Then they split, they went their separate ways, now they're back together again. And wonderful to see them playing so well, the Chinese pair. won last week without dropping a game.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Ayaka Takahashi, Misaki Matsutomo, Japan. And on my left, Yu Xiaohan, Wang Yachong, China. Wang Yachong to serve to Ayaka Takahashi. Level play.
So Wang Yachong getting this women's doubles underway. Gosh, she was impressive last week, Steen. I know you weren't there, but I know you watched it on television. Wang Yachong achieving the first doubles double of the year in elite play, the elite tiers of tournaments.
Supper.
And yeah, of course, her new partnership with Sheng Shiwei.
And that's exactly my point. It's impressive what it can do to sometimes have a little bit of change when you're successful at the beginning, but also a good idea to sort of test it in a Grand Prix Gold event instead of starting off at the highest level.
Yeah.
Two, love.
Women's doubles match, also a very interesting match with the junior world champions there. The Koreans
in the final.
In the final,
yeah.
Really has some strong players coming up.
There's the world junior champions Baek Ha-na and Lee Yoo-eun from Korea. Yes, and they're all playing with different partners this week as well.
Yeah, and I think we talked a little bit about it in the beginning of this session.
One,
here,
three.
That there's a lot of scratch pairs playing at the moment, and I think, I don't know, I mean, it could also be for keeping up the motivation, playing with the youngsters and helping them a little bit, but I also think it's a great way of helping them into to Super Series levels. And we should not forget that next year, entry to Premier Super Series and the tier above that, that we don't really know what's going to be called yet. But there's no qualification there, so either you're in or you're out.
Yeah.
But by helping these players playing a couple of tournaments, you help them get more points.
Yeah.
That could be crucial in terms of getting into tournaments.
Very good point. Oh yes, what an interception from Yu Xiaohan.
We sort of got the game started there.
Four,
what a rally.
Now I think on the coaching bench, I only had a glimpse of him, but apart from Pan Lee, was that Tiao Jiaming? He was
The mixed doubles player.
Yeah.
There's signs that there's definitely more responsibility to Huang Yachong, also in the women's doubles department, since the departure of the Liu twins.
Yep. And Bao Yixin.
Bao Yixin.
Oh, I like that defense.
Match on hole 3 will be women's singles between Zhang Yili from Korea and Gao Fangjie from China.
I think we might see a few of these marathon rallies. Biggest rally of the day, surely.
Umpire, Hou Longwu, China. Service judge, Zhuang Yingying, China.
And it's won by the Chinese pair. Yeah. I think we're right there, Steen, on the coaching front.
Quickly. Yeah,
81
yeah, I think
shots.
I told you, I mean. Yeah, and we talked about it in the last match, this psychological effect of the rallies, and the Chinese pair have won both the two long rallies. Maybe there was actually three, and they won them all.
Yeah.
5-1.
On the side where presumably the Japanese pair would have a little bit easier in terms of killing the shuttles. That has not been the case.
You have to get ready. She's waiting for you.
Well, Christian Johannesson of Denmark, good umpiring, saying that you're taking too long. Your opponents were ready to serve. You've got to get ready quicker. It's gone long.
Time is over. 2-5.
Good judgment. Let's go along. Steen, I just want to pick up on something you were saying a minute ago about the elite tournaments, the three tournaments that are going to be above the Premier Super Series and the Premier. There's no qualifying for any of those. So what if players withdraw injured?
Before the tournament.
If before the tournament, somebody can jump on an aeroplane and get there to replace them.
Seven.
That's really interesting. There's already some rules come out on it, but I haven't seen that situation covered.
No, okay.
I haven't seen. Maybe I've just missed it, but I haven't seen that situation covered. Whether you can, wait. Maybe you ask actually 34 players, pairs, or how many you want in the tournament to be present. But what about the ones that end up not getting in? Do you want them to just sit stand by?
Exactly.
That's
when you think in the French Open, there were 25 withdrawals after the Denmark Open the week before.
Yeah.
And it did, in all honesty, disrupt the draw somewhat.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's been the case for a long time, that we've seen draws being very, very lopsided due to withdrawals on either the upper part or the lower part of the draw.
Yeah. But at least there was players there expecting to play the qualifying. That came into the main draw. So we still had a full main draw.
Yeah.
Anyway, that it just occurred to me. I can understand completely why they've done it and said no qualifying. I understand the whole rationale behind it, but it was just a thought that I had as you were talking about it. Oh, good return of serve. Kai Nakajima, Japanese coach there, living every minute of the match with his players. Oof! That's a lot to think about.
Four.
It.
Thank you.
just wide.
Serve is over. 5-9.
This match is actually quite crucial, I think, for this Japanese pair. Steen, I know that you've been keeping a very, very close eye on the Super Series standings at the moment, because the top three pairs in the women's doubles on the Super Series standings at the moment are all Japanese pair.
Yeah.
Matsutomo and Takahashi are the second-ranked pair.
Nine.
You're only allowed two pairs or two players per discipline in the singles, two pairs in the doubles. Per discipline. Now, Fukushima and Hirota, who are at number three, I don't think they've played their second round match yet, but this all could get very complicated as to which.
Did they play their first round? Of course they did, if they have a second round match. They won that?
I don't know whether they've played already today.
But they won yesterday.
They won yesterday.
Okay.
So, if they were to do better than Matsutomo and Takahashi, and of course the last event next week in Hong Kong, it could all get fairly desperate, and the Olympic champions are in danger of perhaps not qualifying for the Super Series finals.
Yeah, they're only 500 points ahead of Fukushima and Hirota. So, got to do the same as their compatriots to beat them for a spot in the Super Series finals, unless both pairs overtake Shio Tanaka and her partner Yonemoto, who's at the moment leading that race.
There's some work to do by these Japanese coaches here, then, isn't there? All points adrift.
リターンでここを狙うパクカワも同じここ大体ストレート球多いだからあと後ろの人は殺す殺すを準備するこのパターンもちょっと頭の中でね全部センター入ったらセンター入ったら相手やりやすいだから前後はね
Yeah, it looks like when you see the Japanese pair that
11-7.
They're suffering some late post-Olympic blues in many ways, that they won the biggest title possible. And what now? There's still 4 years to go till the Home Olympics in Tokyo, and there's tough competition in their national team, in their daily practice and so on. But
yeah.
So in order to still maintain their level, they probably have to practice even harder than they did before, or even smarter.
Mm.
Whilst everybody's looking at them, and I can see some similarities between these two pairs, that we have a player that is clearly stronger on the front court than her partner on each side of the court, Huang Yachong and Misaki Matsutomo. The thing is here that, in my opinion, Huang Yachong is maybe she's not as strong as Matsutomo on the front court, but she's definitely stronger on the back court. She hits much harder than Japanese player. And, well, Yu Xiaohan, compared to Takahashi, I don't know, but it's the Japanese pair that everybody is wanting to beat.
Mm.
They're looking at them and saying, oh, what do we need to do to beat them and create a pair that can beat them? If we don't have a pair, can we create one then?
Yeah.
We've seen it with Tianqing Chen and Jia Yifan, the world champions, that they've been successful in challenging this Japanese pair on a number of occasions.
13-8.
So it's a tough job to stay on top.
It is. And, I mean, as you were talking there, Steen, having seen Wang Yaxiong this year, because she had an incredible start
to in the mixed
doubles, with Liu Kai. In fact, they have been in four Super Series tournament finals, winning three of them at the beginning of the year.
Yeah.
Now she's playing with Cheng Shiwei, and she's won a women's doubles Super Series title. And I thought last week, watching her, that she gained even more confidence at the front of the court. So as you were talking, I actually said to myself, I think there's a real question mark as to whether it is Matsutomo or Wang who's better at the front of the court. Now, if it's Wang Yaxiong, that's in my book, because this lady we're looking at right now, I think has got the hardest smash on court. Whether she's got the stamina to keep going at the sort of pace that the Japanese pair
That's
questionable. But this is a fascinating encounter.
And also, again, this, I mean, for Matsutomo and Takahashi, this is just another tournament.
Yeah.
Whilst the Chinese pair, I would suspect them to be hungry and sort of try to make a name for themselves and try to establish them in the Chinese team. They probably get a bit more attention than they did before Bao Yixin withdrew, before the Liu twins 14. Withdrew, and so on.
Yeah.
So now they're the ones in focus together with Chen and Jia.
Yeah.
Ladies,
Umpire's not happy.
You need to move it, okay?
Yeah. Good umpiring.
14-10.
Although they're grueling rallies, aren't they? I wouldn't. I'd need a bit of a rest after that, but.
Serve is over.
Knock your neck cord there, but the rules say that play
11,
must be continuous.
14.
Yeah.
And I think the players do push the limits. I think they push the patience of the umpires.
Of course, and they should. If I were a coach and the players didn't push the limit, I would be angry at them.
Mm.
The umpires, they set the standard for how we play.
Yeah. I like that smash because it suddenly was across the body.
Yeah.
No, there's only 2 points in it now. Oh, there's a couple of lucky
A lot of them have come off the net court.
Good rally. Oh, there's another neck cord.
Good.
That is over. 14, 15.
Oh, it was way, way in.
Exactly.
How could you leave that
wait
one?
For the line, Josh.
That's a super shot. Yeah. Made the difference in the rally.
16-14. It's over.
I think technically the Japanese pair is 15, playing better right now, 16. And I think you're spot on with your assessment of the stamina of Yu Xiaohan.
Yeah. Oh my goodness gracious, what happened there? Yeah, totally mistimed it.
Yeah.
17-15.
In terms of tactic and Takahashi and Matsutomo, they simply have to get the Chinese pair to play in the opposite position
18,
compared
15.
To their preferred position with Huang Yacheng at the net. They've got to get her to the backcourt. Not that she's not strong at the backcourt, she's just a lot stronger at the net. And
yeah.
Liu Xiaohan is not a big threat at the net.
Score. Yeah. Service over. 16-18. Again,
just one point in
17,
it.
18.
They are getting nervous in their coaches' chairs, aren't they?
Yeah. There's one thing I've forgotten to look after. That's how is it going with Matsutomo's
serve?
Yeah.
I think it's been a little better of late.
Yeah.
That's kiss of death, probably. Isn't it?
But it's also a very, very legal serve. She's almost serving in knee height.
Oh, my goodness. Extraordinary around the head shot.
Yeah.
The shorts. Oh, my goodness. What a rally. This is unbelievable. Terrific stuff. rally. Well, I wonder if that's beaten the longest rally, which was 81 shots earlier. What a point to get that level. 91 shots, my goodness.
18 all. So Shuttle okay? Shuttle is fine.
Yeah, Shuttle is fine.
Change.
Yeah, some big gulps of air from Wang Yashong too. 18 all. There's throws in the flick when it gets tight. Such an important point. Fabulous. Yeah.
19-18.
Well, four straight points to go into the lead at this crucial stage.
No, stay on the court. Now we play.
Well, the umpire did allow the Japanese pair to tell down earlier, not allowing the Chinese pair on this occasion. Fitness is supposed to be a test of badminton.
Yeah, and in many ways, I like that we cannot go and towel down just because we have a long rally.
Yeah.
But I'd like to see the consistency with all the umpires, that they have the same sense of what it is. The appropriate time in between rallies.
Yeah, now. He allows Matsutomo to go and towel down.
Just toweling.
And also allows the Chinese pair. Okay. Is that telling service error at 19-18?
Yeah.
Make it 19 all?
Yeah, I think it is.
19 all!
Still hasn't got that confidence on the low serve.
No.
So somebody's going to have a game point after this next rally.
Service over. Net court.
20, game point, 19.
Great fight back from the Japanese pair to get themselves a game point here.
Indeed, they convert on their first game point opportunity. 21-19. Well, six of the last 7 points to close out that game. 21-19 in a fraction under 30 minutes.
他们打过的都是没打过，我们这边也是，他们打过的都是没打过，他攻的那个球，我们出席完就好了。这样，他们打过的球都还有点事，怎么结算还是有点事，他们准备打就转接，发球站嘛，发球发出来了，他有病，他如果发球和接管之后怎么？他有没有机会去变速，攻击的边线一直跟着他在跑，他太开了，小麦，所以你们该慢的时候慢下来，该缓的缓下来，然后有一边抓起来，另外一边。
So I think Pan Lee and Tao Xiaoming will be a little disappointed that their pair, having had a 5-point advantage at one stage and 13-8, were unable to convert on that opening game. But it is the Olympic champions who took the opening game, 21-19.
Yeah, it was almost a steal. It was almost a steal.
Yeah.
Because the Chinese pair, they were in command, but I think a good tactical change and some luck of the net court helped the Japanese pair. Interested to see one of the things that I feel that the Chinese should discuss is how do we go about our business when Huang Yachong is on the backcourt? Because in the last part of the first game, they pretty much, the Japanese pair, they played 2-1 against Huang Yachong, making her run around Yu Xiaohan, who did not get into anything, and who, in my opinion, looked a little bit tired from the backcourt.
Yeah.
And they just won the Macau Open. They cannot have gotten back here until Monday or something like that, and it's a long travel from Macau, you know that, Jill. 12 hours, even though it's not that far in distance, but it's not so easy to get from Macau to Fuzhou.
No.
Yeah, well played. Oi.
Much flatter smash.
One of the hardest clears we've seen in this match.
And so Tomo just asking her coaches, would that have gone long? Look how flat this is. It's aimed towards her head.
Yeah.
That's very nice, isn't it?
Service over.
There they are. They're looking a bit glum, aren't they? Here you are. Here's my quiz question of the day for you. Tao Xiaoming won the mixed doubles title here in 2011. Who was his partner? I'm going to leave you to ponder that for a couple of minutes.
Yeah, he played really good. He played normal mixed doubles with this controlling backcourt game, but was his partner.
Wasn't his usual partner when he won here in 2011. You're at a loss?
Yeah, I think so. I don't think I'll.
So you'll bang the tees tonight then?
Yeah. I've got to call a friend.
Ooh, that's wild. I'll put you out of your misery.
Yeah.
Tian Qing. And I think that was the only mixed double Super Series title that Tian Qing won. I'm not sure about that. I'd have to check that.
But she won some in women's doubles with other partners than Zhao Yunli.
Yes, she did. It's going wide.
Yeah.
Service over. 5-2.
It seems to me, Steen, as if this Chinese pair, they started off very buoyant. They've just won a title last week.
Yep.
And it's almost as if the bubble's been burst and they're a little bit deflated now.
But it's also credit to the Japanese pair.
Absolutely.
because they started out just smashing away. Now they move the Chinese pair around first.
Oh,
perfect.
Yeah.
6-2. Wipe the court, please. Bye, judge.
I was wrong.
No, Jill.
Tiang Qing won 2 Super Series titles with Jia. Tell Charming.
She did.
She did. Both were here in China when the China Masters was a
Super Series.
A Super Series, yep. I think.
7-2.
Amazing, isn't it? For most of that opening game, you felt the Chinese were in control, 13-8 up. Even from the early stages, one stage they had a 5-point advantage, 9-4.
Yeah, and they got off to a really, really good start where they just dominated from the defense and played counter badminton, counter attack.
And now, quite frankly, I can't see a way that they can win this match.
No.
But part of it is because of the Japanese pair.
Yeah, I mean, they had a number of lucky net calls. I think they have, we don't have statistics on that, but I think it was like 3-1 of the big ones that I counted. And that's exactly what the difference was in the game. So had it been the opposite, where 1-3, they would have lost with 17. The Chinese would have come out with some spirit and hopes to get it done in 2. Now they know they have to get to a third game, and the way I see it, Yu Xiaohan looks a little bit spent.
Yeah.
And it really helped them also when they started working Huang Yachong. It helped the Japanese pair when they started working Huang Yachong around the court instead of having her more or less controlling the front court.
4-9. A quick towel and then in. And that's it. Service over. 10.
She was a threat in the 2/3 of the first game. Yu Xiaohan, she's not a threat any longer.
No.
See that she's definitely not comfortable playing the front court.
Service.
another net cord. Would you believe it? After the mid-game interval, now with a 7-point advantage. We should have been keeping account of those, Steen.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
You can really see the pronation of the forearm there, couldn't you?
Yeah.
It's great images.
Again there. Yeah, Matsutomo looking at the umpire. Chinese player talking a lot to each other.
That is over.
After they were back in court.
5-11.
Rally for Chinese pair.
Oh my goodness! How did she play that backhand? My goodness me, look at the court that Matsutomo is covering.
Good work.
What a fabulous run. I expect that might have been the longest rally of the second game. Nowhere near the longest rally. Oh yes, well taken.
Yeah,
it was almost as if Lucia Han didn't really know what to do there in that front court position.
Yeah, she has no idea.
No. Do I push it? Do I try and play a net shot? What do I do? It was, obviously we don't know, but it looked to me as if she had total indecision. There's indecision there, there's no doubt about that.
And since the interval in the first game where the Japanese were down 7-11, it's 14-8, 15-5.
Mm.
That's significant.
Yeah.
Look how much Wang Yachong is playing from the backcourt now.
Mm.
Moving her around.
16-5.
Oh, tactical work by Takahashi and Matsutomo.
Has she played her mixed doubles yet, or is that still to come?
I think it's still to come.
Because look at the, what her reaction after that rally.
Yeah.
She's tired. So
it's very common that you start thinking about... No, she has played. All Chinese affair.
Yeah. And
won it.
Quite convincingly, yeah. Oh, well, there's a little bit of concern here because Wang Yaoxiong is down, not quite out. Her partner has left her to get medical treatment while she's talking to coaches. Now, what's the medical timeout for here? I mean, she did sort of, after that rally, sort of go down on her knees and stayed there. I thought it was just tiredness, Steve, but perhaps...
It could be a blister or something.
She hurt herself. Chris Lawrence, the deputy referee. Here we go. Ooh. Oh, didn't really see it. Stopped before we could see whether she went over on that ankle.
No, I don't think she did that.
No. And the medical team. Oh, I think she has got strapping on that ankle. Can you? It's difficult for us to see. The deputy referee is standing between us and the player. Or maybe it was a sock. No, there is strapping, isn't there? Well, the medical team are leaving. Yeah, there is strapping. She's putting on her sock now. There we go.
It could also be the strapping that's sort of fallen down a little bit and is sitting in an awkward position.
Yeah.
The Japanese player is asking the umpire how much time has... gone with this injury.
There isn't a specific time limit,
no.
Though, in badminton, is there? Medics need to assess the injury, and we're not seeing it, but I can tell you, just as she finishes stretching, she was actually stretching what looked like an Achilles. But the strapping looks like ankle strapping.
Yeah. And the thing is that if she withdraws from this match...
She can't play her mixed.
She can't play her mixed.
No.
16-5.
Mixed quarterfinal tomorrow. So whatever happens from her mixed doubles perspective, she needs to finish this women's doubles encounter. I seem to recall from the World Championship scene when Wu Xiao Han was playing with Bao Yixin, and in the quarterfinal against this same Japanese pair, they were way down in the second game. They'd lost the first, they were 2-15 down in the second, and then Xiao Han had a medical timeout, and they ended the Chinese pair ended up winning that second game, if you recall, 27-25. From 2-15 down.
Yeah. I think
18-5.
I think that's right. Yeah, that was absolutely amazing because they'd lost the first game convincingly, right?
Yeah, to 13. It's no wonder then that the Japanese pair were saying, come on.
They almost... I mean, they were almost in the dressing room.
Yeah.
and then they had to play three games.
Mm. Don't think the same thing's going to happen here. They're just 3 points away from the quarter final. What would be a sixth quarter final here for the Japanese pair?
19-5.
Match points galore.
20, match point 5.
A moment of defiance.
And again, look how much Huang Yachong is being made to work on the backcourt. It pretty much takes Yu Xiaohan out of the game, so they're playing two against one. Of course, heavy advantage for the Japanese. And that part of the game.
So safely through to the quarterfinal, the Olympic champions and the number one seeds, 21-19, 21-6, in a match lasting 53 minutes.
Match won by Misaki Matsutomo, Ayaka Takahashi, 21-19, 21-6.
Well, from 15-18 down in that opening game, the Japanese pair only dropping another 7 points in total. That's extraordinary. There's confirmation of the scoreline, 21-19, 21-6. So that concludes today's matches, and as you can see, all of our matches in two straight games. It all started with a repeat of the women's singles final from 3 years ago. And in a contrast to the final 3 years ago, today it was Yamaguchi who won, because Sina Nawa won the title in 2014. Then it was men's doubles, and it was the reigning world champions, the number five seeds Liu Cheng and Jiang Nang, who were just too good for the new Malaysian pair of Ong Yu Sin and Tam Wee Keong. Tam Wee Keong, a former finalist here at the China Open. Then it was men's singles, and Lee Chong Wei, three-time finalist and winner here 2 years ago, played against his nemesis, Boris Lavades, the man who beat him in the first round of the World Championships in Glasgow. My goodness, didn't Lee Chong Wei make it look easy today? 21-6, 21-9 in just 31 minutes. Then we had a second men's singles, and the world champion, Victor Axelsen, the number one seed, he cruised through against Chiao Bin of China in 42 minutes, 12 and 14, the scoreline there. And then, as we've just seen, the Olympic champions and the beaten finalists here 2 years ago, Matsutomo and Takahashi, from 15-18 down in the first, won the match, dropping only another 7 points in total, because six of the last 7 points of the opening game to win it 21-19 and 21-6 in the second. So safely through to their sixth quarterfinal here at the China Open. Quarterfinals tomorrow, 1600 local time. That's 0800 GMT. From Steen and myself, Jill Clark, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now.
on court 3 will be women's doubles between Jing Wing Chan, Yang Qin Cheng from China's Taipei, and Yuko Fukushima, Sayaka Hirota.
Your team, 技术官员入场。